From Dublin, I'm heading straight across Ireland towards the rugged west coast. Being from the land of wide open spaces, I've got to say I wasn't too comfortable travelling these narrow laneways that pass as main roads. By the end of the trip, I felt in need of a stiff drink. So I headed to a small bar in the township of Lahinch to meet what many believe is the oldest barman in Ireland, 86-year-old Tom Frawley. Tom has been pouring drinks for 77 years. And he was ecstatic to feature in my film. Pouring a good Guinness takes time, and Tom knew this better than anyone. I've got to say I love Ireland, a land of myth and music, of poets and rebels. I mean, where else would someone quote poetry to you outside the local pub?
From east to west and north and south, the mighty legends came with floating flags and beating drums to win immortal fame. From Belfast down, or that famous town that looks upon the sea, all joined that day in that fearful fray that set their errand free. We'll be on time, mate. Thoughts up.
I've stopped into the small village of Doolin. Doolin has made a name for itself through its traditional music sessions. I went straight to the source, interviewing local banjo player, Kevin Griffin.
Well, I've been playing, I suppose, for about 26, 27 years now, banjo. I play a bit of guitar as well, and mandolin and stuff, but banjo's my main instrument. There's three pubs at the moment in Doolin. Every one of them have traditional music at night. We all skip around, you know what I mean? And everybody sits in with everybody, you know what I mean? I could be playing with two or three different people tomorrow night. The next night it could be different again, you know. We all come in together, you know, and we all play. And it's constant from about April on. It's very busy, you know. See, you're guaranteed music here 7 nights a week. That's a big thing, you know, winter or summer, you know. So I think people all over the world are so fond of Irish music is spread out so much. They're so fond of it that they all want to come here to play and meet the locals and meet whatever, you know. I think with Irish music, myself personally, in this area, I think everybody here was brought up with it. What people used to do in the old days, when there was no TV, no telephones, nothing, people used to visit each other's houses at night. They'd put down a big fire, especially in the winter time. They'd go to each other's houses. They'd loads of people go to one house. They'd start telling stories. And then they might have play tunes and they might sing songs, and that could go into the early hours of the morning. It could go, you know, could go into the next day maybe, you know. And I think that's how it evolved, and you know, and it's a part of life here. It's a way of life. It's what we do. You can sit in the session with anybody, you know. Everybody's welcome in the sessions. Anybody can sit in. You could have a quiet night, you could have you know, maybe two or three people playing. The next night you could have 10 people playing, you know. That's the beauty of it. It's absolutely brilliant. It's great, you know, and any person could walk in after all, and famous, you know, not famous, whatever, you know. That's brilliant. It's great. It's not a competition, you know. You try your best, you come up, people come up to you and say, can I sing a song? They might have one verse of a song, you know. They might have 10 verses, and you might be saying to yourself, oh God, when is this person going to stop, you know. But it's brilliant that way. You don't know. When somebody comes into you and says, can I join the session? You don't know what that person is going to be doing, you know. Whether he's going to be he or she or whatever. He's going to be good, bad or indifferent, and you accept all that, you know. The session is open to everybody. That's the thing, you know. Everybody is accepted, and that's what makes it so lovely and interesting. Yeah.